Hello friends, welcome back to our lecture series on game theory and its applications. In the last lecture, we discussed the Cournot model where two firms were simultaneously choosing what quantities to produce and we got interesting results. And then now comes the Bertrand model. So a brief history behind this model. Actually, Bertrand was reviewing Cournot's book. And then he was not convinced with Cournot's idea of quantity choice in duopoly. So as a criticism of this, he talked about the scenario where two firms are simultaneously choosing prices rather than quantity. But then he didn't give a formal model. The model was formally developed by F.Y. Esworth in 1889. But then this is named after Bertrand, because he was the first to point out this idea of choosing the prices rather than quantity. So let's start our discussion. So we now know that Bertrand was emphasizing on prices rather than quantity. So this model can be studied in two variants, and we will study both variants in due course of time. One variant is differentiated product, where the products are not identical. So it's like yellow chalk and white chalk. So you can differentiate based on the color. And another one is homogeneous product model, that we will be discussing in the next lecture. So today's lecture is based solely on Gibbons' game theory for applied economists. So the way he has discussed Bertrand model for differentiated product, we are going to use that, because that's pretty intuitive and easy to understand. So the situation is like this. There are two firms which are selling a differentiated product, and each firm is choosing price for its product simultaneously and independently of the other firm. So both are, it's like that both are declaring the prices together. Or we have discussed that one firm has declared the price, but the other firm doesn't know what it has declared. So when the other firm is choosing price, it's like it's choosing together with the first firm. That's the idea of simultaneity. So the demand for the consumers, demands by the consumers for the product of the firm I. So it will be given like quantity by the firm I, given when the firm I choosing price PI, firm J choosing a price PJ, is given as A minus B minus PI. PI is the price by the firm I itself, plus BPJ. PJ is the firm J's price, and B is the extent to which the product, it should be D here, so sorry for the typo, extent to which the product of the firm I and firm J are substitute for each other. So for a perfect substitute, B will take a value 1, and for perfect complement, B will take a value 0. So here we are assuming that B is greater than 0, so products are not perfect complement, they are substitute up to some degree at least. Now further assuming about the cost situation, so we are assuming for simplicity there is no fixed cost, and MC is given as C, and this is a constant. And we also assume that this MC is less than A, because if A is actually the vertical intercept of the demand curve A, if your cost is going above this, then there will be no point in producing and selling anything, because you will not be covering your average cost of production. You will be getting negative profit, and no firm will be willing to take negative profits. Fine. So now usual practice of writing the normal form of the game. So we know the players are the firm I and J here. The strategies are defined as SI from 0 to infinity. This is the strategy space of firm I, and the action they have, SI, is a price choice PI. And this could be greater than or equal to 0. Prices cannot be negative, so we are dealing with non-negative numbers. Preferences, they are represented by the payoff function of each firm, and it is given like this. Profit of the firm I when it's choosing a price PI while the other firm PJ, firm J is choosing a price PJ is equal to quantity by firm I when the price is PI and PJ multiplied with price of firm I minus C. So why we are writing like this? That's simple to understand. See, this particular portion is giving us quantity QI and this PI minus C is actually the average profit. So you multiply average profit with the quantity, so you are getting the total profit. Okay. There is again another typo. This bracket should have actually closed here. So understand that it is written like this: A minus PI plus B PJ. This is PI minus C. So the same thing that I denoted here. So now if it is given like this, then we have to find the Nash equilibrium of this particular Bertrand model. So we know that we go by this way, that if we are getting a price pair, that is PI star and PJ star, if it is a Nash equilibrium, then it should be able to solve the profit maximization for problem for the firm I J. So it is written like this: max profit of firm I given the price choices. So I have written here the total form of the profit. So this is the quantity multiplied by the average profit, that will make the total profit. So now let's use our trusted friend OneNote to solve this manually and see the how to get the answer of this. So I have written this already here. So let's start with this. So what we do in the optimization thing, we need to simply first expand this. So I am going to write this. Come on, bhai. This is equal to A PI minus PI square plus B PI PJ minus AC plus C PI minus C B PJ. Okay, so this is the total equation for the profit. So how we do that? We take the first derivative with respect to the price of firm I or J, whatever you want to solve it for, and set it equal to 0. So I am doing it like this. I am solving it for pi I. So this becomes A minus 2 pi I plus B PJ. This part we don't have any pi I, so this became 0, plus again here we have a pi I here, so plus C minus, here we don't have any pi I, so this became 0. We are setting this total equal to 0. So we get 2 pi I is equal to A plus B PJ and plus C, or we get pi I is equal to A plus B PJ plus C by 2. Oh, sometimes out of hurry I spoil the curry. So this is our equation 1, and because the forms are identical, so we can write similarly pj is equal to a plus b pi plus c by 2. This is the second one. So we need to solve them together to get the values of pi and pj. So solving 1 and 2, we get pi is equal to half a plus b. Now in case in place of pj, I am going to replace this value here. So this becomes a plus b pi plus c by 2 plus c. This is what we got. So from here you may actually put this also under bracket so that we don't get confused. So this will make pi is equal to half 2a plus ba plus b square pi plus bc plus 2c by 2. So once we have done this, then pi is equal to 1 by 4 2a plus ba plus b square pi plus bc plus 2c. So let's take similar terms at one side. So we are going to write 4 pi minus b square pi is equal to 2a plus ba plus bc plus 2c. So what we are going to do, we are taking here pi as common and writing this 4 minus b square is equal to, here I am taking a common, so this became 2 plus b plus, here I am taking c as common, so this became 2 plus b. So now what happens that I am going to solve it for pi, so this became a plus c into 2 plus b upon 4 minus b square. And now we can write actually 4 minus b square, we can visualize this as 2 square minus b square, so this is a square minus b square. So we are going to write it like this, a plus c 2 plus b 2 minus b 2 plus b. So this is struck off and we realize that our equilibrium price for form I is going to be a plus c upon 2 minus b, and because the forms are identical, so this is also going to be the form J's price. You may as an exercise you may try solving and seeing it for yourself. So this is fine. Now let's solve this for quantity. So we know that since qi pi pj is given by this particular expression a minus pi plus b pj, so we can actually write q qi is equal to a minus, now I have the value of pi, so I am writing that here. So this is a plus c upon 2 minus b plus b, and I also have value of pj, that is same as a plus c upon 2 minus b. So now we have this, so we need to solve this and get our value of qi and qj. So let's solve this. So we will be writing a, actually why to do anything else, let's solve from here itself the old method. I will be taking this 2 minus b, and then this is a into 2 minus b minus a minus a minus c plus b a plus b c. So let's expand this. So this will be 2a minus ab minus a minus c plus ba plus bc. So this is struck off, this is struck off. So we realize that we get our qi star, that up equilibrium quantity, as a minus c plus bc by 2 minus b, and this will be same for qj star as well. So okay, so now we have got this. What we need to find now, we have find price as well as quantity, so now we need to find pi 1 and pi 2. So we know that pi I is given as a minus pi plus b pj into pi I minus c. So, and we also know that a minus pi I plus b pj is nothing but qi, and we have value of qi that we have solved, and this is a minus c plus bc upon 2 minus b. So let's use this. So I'm writing here pi I is equal to a minus c plus bc upon 2 minus b, and then we have to multiply this with pi minus c, and we have realized that pi was a plus c upon 2 minus b and then minus c. So we realize that we have to, when we are solving this, we will get in this part will be as it is, a minus c plus bc upon 2 minus b. What about the other part? We will be actually expanding this. So this will be a plus c minus 2c plus bc by 2 minus b. So there are things to strike off. So I will be striking that off, and then you will realize that we are left with same terms in both sides, a minus, not sides, in both the expressions 2 minus b, and this will also become a minus c plus bc upon 2 minus b. So now we get that pi I star, that is equilibrium profit of form I, will be same as equilibrium profit of the form J, and then this is the value that you will be getting whole square. So this was our Bertrand model. You can actually think about some interpretations. So what happened that if they are perfect substitute, then we will have this 2 minus 1 because B will take value 1. So it will become 1. So the price will be A plus C only. What about the quantity? Again, in place of B, we have to write 1. So this will be A minus C plus C. That will be cancelling off. And this will be 1. So quantity will be just A. And then profit will also, you can actually put the value of B is equal to 1 and solve for it and get that what will be the profit in this situation. So that was the Bertrand model with differentiated product or heterogeneous product model. So let me know if you have any questions about this, we can actually answer. And then in the next lecture, we will be taking up Bertrand homogeneous product model, and that's actually much more interesting than this very fascinating model and complex than this also. So till then, happy learning and take care. Bye.